Rituals for Transformation, 108-Day Journey to Your Sacred Life. What I'm doing in this series is I go through a section of the book each day as it pertains to the lesson that I'm on. Today for me is day 19, and the lesson is The Way I Use My Words Has an Impact on the World. If you are interested in following along with me in the book and doing your own journey, I do link it in the description. So without further ado, let me hop right into it. So for me, a couple of the big takeaways for today's lesson was, since it was all around words, it was about that your words have power. And I don't know if you've heard this before, but I've heard this recently, that the word spelling comes from spell, like casting a spell on someone. So in a way, when you speak your words, you are casting a spell out into the world, you know, out into the universe. The words you speak have power, and they also have the power to uplift the person you're speaking them to, or they can break them down. So be very careful with your words. You can cause harm, or you can cause someone to feel better about themselves and go forth into the world and be a better person. Also, I do believe in karma, so be careful with that. This also includes social media. So if you are someone who goes online and puts a lot of information out there like I do, just be careful with the words that you choose and try to be positive with other people, because you never know what the effect could be on them. They could, you know, be having already a bad day, and that could just set them over the edge. This includes even like just writing little comments or anything like that that could have a negative effect on someone. Think about it before you do it and choose your words wisely. The next thing I wanted to talk about, and this was also mentioned in the lesson today, was breaking generational curses. And what I mean by that is sometimes there are thoughts and ideas that are passed down from generation to generation. And these things can be subconsciously in the mind just from growing up in a certain environment. Certain ideas can be passed down from generations and generations before, and distant ancestors could have planted the seeds. So sometimes when you think something before you speak it, think, is this really coming from me, or is this from somewhere deep, but you know, deep in the past that I'm not even aware of? So this can bring light to things that could be generational curses that have been passed down. The next thing I want to talk about is your inner voice. And we've talked about this in another video, but speaking negatively to yourself. Try not to speak negative words to yourself, and always try to be positive and uplifting. And if you do hear that negative inner voice coming out, then try to refocus your mind on something positive, or think of something that makes you happy and change that inner dialogue just a little bit. Small changes can make a big difference in the long run. The next thing I want to talk about is how I set up this meditation today. For me, I've been experimenting with different chakras related to the lesson, and then also matching up the music that I meditate to the frequency of that chakra. So today I chose the throat chakra. I thought it would be very appropriate since we are talking about words and the power they have. And I chose to listen to music that was set at 741 hertz. Now I've seen two different theories on what hertz the throat chakra vibrates at, and they are 672 or 741, but today I chose music that vibrated at 741 hertz. And I did see some pretty quick results from that. My meditation seemed to go very smooth, and I got some immediate realizations as soon as I popped down into my meditative state. So I want to share those with you, and one of them was not necessarily about the words you speak to others, but as I said before, also the words that you speak to yourself. And this also involves speaking your truth. So not stuffing your feelings and blocking that throat chakra, letting your truth come out and expressing your feelings and thoughts to other people when it comes to your boundaries or anything else that you need to share. Obviously, we do want to speak these words with kindness and love and not use them to break others down, but it's also bad to stuff all those feelings inside and not let them out. And the visualization I had in this meditation that really helped me sink this in was very interesting. It was of my favorite movie as a child, The Little Mermaid. And the scene where her voice is leaving her and going to Ursula. So you see this bright white light coming out, and her voice is being taken out of her. And that was the very strong visualization imaging that I got in this meditation. And for me, it made me think about the fact that she gave up her voice in exchange for legs and love. And she was also not being heard by her father. That was like a big part of this entire movie is, you know, she tried to express her wishes to her father. She wasn't being heard. So in a sense, she just gave her voice away and stopped talking about it. And then she thought in exchange for that, she would get what she was looking for, which was love and acceptance and with another man. And you see how that turned out. So in the end, she did get her voice back. And I think that is an important lesson for all of us is don't give your voice up for something when if you're seeking validation or approval or love, don't give your voice up. Keep your voice. You can still get these things out of life, but it's important that we are aware of when we're giving our voice up and when we're not speaking our truth. And for me, that was a powerful message for me because I've told you guys before, I'm a people pleaser, and sometimes I try to hide my feelings and not speak my truth. So for me, I think this was a valuable lesson, and I really appreciate you guys watching. Let me know what you got out of this lesson if you're following along in the book. And again, if you enjoyed this, please like and subscribe, and thank you again. Bye.